All right, so you're in this stupid drop coverage where you give Luka Doncic a 2-on-1 in the lane. So that's obviously not going to work. What if I want to take a look at if we switch this, okay? Rudy Gobert's up. This player's underneath, battling for real estate, initiating contact. Now I can force Luka Doncic right into gap help right here. See, this player can just stunt without moving his feet inward and recover. So isn't that a better solution than giving up a 2-on-1? This is why you switch underneath the screener here. Stop. So this screen gets set. So right now, Conley's got to get underneath and jamming for real estate, initiating contact. You can't front the post here, okay, or the high post. Right now, you got to be underneath Doncic. Why is that? Because this player can just slide in a little bit. And now we force Doncic this way, and we can dig and recover. But instead, you're fronting Doncic. So now they're just going to throw this ball over the top. Okay, and look, now he's right into the lane, and it's an easy two. See, I'm not running drop coverage here. You're just giving Luka Doncic the lane, and it's an easy layup. Look at if we switch this. Okay, let's take a look. Get underneath the screener. You're fine. Battle for real estate. Initiate contact. And Rudy Gobert is here. Now all I'm doing is just sending Doncic this way. This player can move in a little bit. As long as he doesn't have to move his feet inward, he'll always get back outward. So we're just going to stunt and easily recover. But we're going to close off Doncic's driving lane. But I mean, instead, you're just giving him the lane. I mean, how easy is that? If you're doubling Jalen Brunson's post up, the double team cannot come from Rudy Gobert, okay? This player's got to slide over here, okay? Now Rudy Gobert's up the line, all right? If the kickout pass gets made here, he rotates here. This player rotates here. This player rotates here. And the man that doubles immediately rotates into the corner. All those rotations happen in unison on the first kickout pass. But instead, Rudy Gobert is going to like sort of double team, but not really. And now Jalen Brunson's just going to play bully ball and get into the lane for a two-shot foul. Okay, so this player here is guarding this player here. So off of this ball screen right here, stop. Whiteside is guarding is dropping towards the ball. So why is this player here and his man here? Whiteside is covering the ball. But you're just standing in no man's land, so you give up a wide open catch and shoot three. All right, strong side ISO here. I'm doubling this every time. It's way too easy not to. Okay, this player comes over here, and we just force this player this way. This player's up the line on a drive and kick. He rotates here. Okay, this player needs to be over here because he's rotating here. And then this player, the man that doubles, goes here and bumps this player to the corner. But instead, you're just going to let Jalen Brunson go 1-on-1. And it's not even a chance, and it's a two-shot foul. All right, strong side ISO here. I'm doubling this every time. It's way too easy not to. Okay, this player comes over here, and we just force this player this way. This player's up the line on a drive and kick. He rotates here. Okay, this player needs to be over here because he's rotating here. And then this player, the man that doubles, goes here and bumps this player to the corner. But instead, you're just going to let Jalen Brunson go 1-on-1. And it's not even a chance, and it's a two-shot foul. Another strong side ISO. I'm doubling this every time. It's way too easy. Again, come over here. Drive and kick. Okay, I slide here. This player slides here. This player slides here. And this player just goes into the corner. All of those happen in unison on the first kickout pass. But again, you're just going to let Jalen Brunson fry you. Draw help baseline, and it's an open three. You can't go under this ball screen with Doncic. I mean, seriously, I mean, get out of here with that. Okay, so right here, I would switch this. Okay, I'm up and I'm switching. All right, this player's underneath. Okay, battle for real estate, initiate contact. But essentially, when this player cuts through, it turns into a strong side ISO. So these are easy to double. This player comes here. This player's just going to rotate here. This player rotates here, and the man that doubles is going to fall onto the screener and push the player that switched onto the screener into the corner. But instead, you're going under, and it's just like, what do you think's going to happen? Mavericks are in the bonus. That's something you've got to note here. So again, if you're Rudy Gobert, you go straight up if you're going for this offensive rebound. Okay, you got to show your hands and go straight up. Is Rudy Gobert going to go straight up and show his hands? Nope, he's going to shove this player for no reason, and now it's a cheap foul, and Dallas is going to the line. This is very elementary right here. Look at how Rudy Gobert is boxing out. You can't box out using the side of your body, okay? Like, you've got to, okay, let's back it up. As soon as this shot goes up, stop. I am re get wrapping my left foot this way, using my butt, getting this player out of the paint, okay? When you this isn't boxing out. Look at him. He's boxing out using the side of his body. So now this, of course, this player gets an easy offensive rebound, and it ends up being a two-shot foul. See, if Jordan Clarkson right here is guarding with his back, his back's to the sideline. If all he's got to do is just open up, back to the baseline. Now there's no place for Dinwiddie to go. But because your back's to the sideline, now you give Dinwiddie space, and he's just going to blow by his man and draw a wide-open corner three. Don't guard past the three-point line away from the ball ever. You got to drop here, okay? Be in the gaps. So look, now when Luka Doncic comes this way, I'm here. So now I can stunt. I don't have to move my feet at all. I do not have to move my feet an inch. Okay, I can stunt, then I'll easily be able to recover. But look at this. You're guarding past the three-point line. So now Luka Doncic has a driving lane he certainly doesn't need, and it's an easy two. You want to make this player use the screen. Stop. Okay, right here. Okay, I just want to guard one-on-one and make this player use the screen, and our ball screen defense can execute. I can't guard one-on-one when I'm leaning towards the screen like this. And now Jalen Brunson gets right into the lane and draws a two-shot foul. I have to send Jalen Brunson in to help. Okay, look at this player right here. He's ready to help. So get up, force him this way. There's no place to go. This player can stunt without having to move his feet inward and easily recover. But instead, you're going to send him away from any help. So now he gets right to the rim, and it ends up being an easy offensive rebound and eventually a putback for two. Okay, you can't do this like switch, then switch back thing. Stop, okay? Rudy Gobert, just stay here, all right? Again, this player's coming here. I'm up and cutting this player's dribble off this way. There's no place to go because Rudy Gobert is standing right here in the gaps. But you're going to try and switch back when the player's one pass away. So now it's just rip and go into the lane and and one. This is just a really stupid foul. The Mavericks are in the bonus. Stop. This player's dribble's picked up. So all Rudy Gobert has got to do is get up in this player's face and show your hands. All right? Look at this. See how we can't see Rudy Gobert's hands? So that's a cheap foul, and the Mavericks go to the line. Okay, again, this is terrible defense. Stop it right here. Stop. You don't guard with your back to the sideline. Open up. Back to the baseline. This player needs to get up and send this player here. There's no place to go. Stunt without moving my feet. Easy recovery. But there's no gap help whatsoever. This player is just going to put Eric Pascal on skates. Jalen Brunson is. And it's an easy two. Okay, well, we know we can't sag on Luka Doncic. Stop. This is the shell drill. Literally the shell drill. This player's right foot can be parallel to the block, left foot out, wide stance. This player gets up in Luka Doncic's airspace, okay, and just forces him here. This player can even get up the line a little bit. But we're going to stunt, and we're going to recover, okay? We're just going to get this dribble picked up all the way out here. But sagging on Luka Doncic is never an option. Not ever. You're guarding Doncic full court. So where do I want to get beat? I want to turn my hips and send him this way where there's nothing but multiple defenders waiting for him. When you let yourself get beat this way, that isn't the case. So now look what's going to happen. Doncic is just going to cross over. There's no one to help you out, and it's a 2 points at the end of the quarter. Have to defend the down screen first. Stop. This is where you get broken down here. This player's got to be attached to his man and have his arms out. So this player cannot just curl right off this down screen. You got to force him out so this chase can happen. Look what happens when you let him curl. See? There's already space now. Okay, so now you're not guarding one-on-one. Then you're going to run drop coverage. You have no chance to fight over the top because you're so far from behind, and it's just an alley-oop. This is the problem with drop coverage. You're running drop coverage off of consecutive Mavericks ball screens. Look at this. Everybody collapse on Luka because you just gave him the lane, and it's going to lead to a wide-open catch-and-shoot three. So right here, I'm just going to switch all of these. All right? I'm switching all of them. Why can I switch all of them? Okay, so now Rudy Gobert is here. This player's here. Donovan Mitchell's here. Okay, now if I'm Rudy Gobert, I just cut Doncic's dribble off, send him right here where we should have gap defenders here who both switched onto those Maverick screeners. But instead, you're just handing Luka Doncic the lane, and of course, everybody collapse, and it leads to a wide open three. Again, you cannot run drop coverage with Luka Doncic here. Look at this. You just handed him a wide open three for no reason. Okay, So again, what would I be doing off this ball screen? I'm immediately switching this ball screen. When this player rolls through, it's now a strong side ISO. Okay, so right now, let's see. So this player is going to roll through. All right, fine. But now look. Now I can bring a double team right here. What does that do? Now this player can rotate here on a drive and kick. This player rotates here. As this man goes through, the man that went to double right here rotates onto the man cutting through. And then the man guarding the man cutting through comes to the corner. But, I mean, you're just running this drop coverage, and it's just you're just handing Doncic wide open threes. All right, so you're running drop coverage on Luka Doncic. I just so don't agree with this. This guard has to fight over the top, and of course it's a two-shot foul. So you're just giving Doncic the lane. See, I'm switching this ball screen right here, okay, up. When this player cuts through, this turns into a 1-3 ISO. So right here, this player now can just come over and double, right? All right, this player rotates up here. This man that goes with the man that cuts through just rotates here. And the man that doubles falls into the man that rotates or that cuts through there. Okay, and now we're just doubling and rotating and preventing Doncic's drive and the three-point line. But instead, you're just giving Doncic the lane, and of course it results in a two-shot foul. Yeah, I mean, if this player is going to so blatantly come over and double-team stop, this player's got to be communicating, okay, and saying, watch your back, watch your back, watch your back, so this player can immediately pick up his dribble, okay? And now I can hit you and you're wide open. I don't know if this is communicated or not, but this player keeps his dribble alive, and now it's just a steal and a two-on-one and an easy layup. See, again, I can't run drop coverage with Doncic. You're just giving him the lane. I mean, this is too easy. Okay, so let's take a look. Again, I'm just switching this. Why can I just so easily switch this? Because look right here. If I'm up and I force Doncic this way, there's no place to go. There's a defender right here in the gaps. So just switch. Why am I just handing Luka Doncic the lane? That doesn't work. I mean, again, where are you getting beat here? Stop. I want to... You got to flip your hips. If you force Jalen Brunson this way, there's no place to go. And there's a second defender who we can't see on our screen right behind him. But instead, you get beat this way. There's no help whatsoever. And Jalen Brunson gets right to the rim, and it's an and one. Yeah, I mean, you just blatantly can't do this if you're Bogdanović. Stop. Look at Bogdanović. Look at his head. Why is it not on his guy? This pass is in midair. You need to be getting out. But because you're staring at, I really don't know what, now you're not out, so it's a wide open three. Okay, so we know we can't sag on Jalen Brunson, okay? That's for sure. Now, when this player cuts through, this turns into a 1-3 ISO. So now I can just come over and double. So get up, send him into a double team, all right? A drive and kick, this player starts to cheat up and rotates up here. This player rotates here, and the man that doubles just falls onto this player. But you can't sag on Jalen Brunson. Just cannot fall asleep on Jalen Brunson here. Stop. You're guarding Jalen Brunson, so you got to go with him, right? Look, he's going out to the three-point line. You cannot lollygag. Look at this. Look at this lollygag right here. Look at this player lollygag. Why? Stop. Jalen Brunson's sprinting to the three-point line. You need to sprint to the three-point line. But you lollygag like that, and now he's open for three. You have to stay level to your man. So right now you're level to Jalen Brunson. What is this player doing right here? Stop. This is not level to Jalen Brunson. You're here. Brunson's here. So you're going to have a hard time getting back out because you just made your route to getting back out much more difficult. You can't get your feet set. Open jumper. All right, so Mike Conley's doubling here. This is a 1-3 ISO. This is a great, look at, great double team. So make sure you send this player here because now what? Now I can get up the line and send this player this way. This player then can get up the line, rotate here, and then Conley can rotate to this third Mavericks option in the corner. But instead, you're going to get beat away from where that double team comes from. Now you got to double at the rim. So now what are you going to do? There's no one to rotate to the weak side wing, okay? And it's going to lead to an open catch-and-shoot three. All right, you switch this ball screen. I absolutely love it. But again, this is a strong side ISO now. These are so easy to double team. Just come over here. Get up, force this player this way. This player gets up the line, rotates here. This player's up the line, rotates here. This player rotates here, and this player falls all the way to that fourth Mavericks option in the corner. All those rotations happen in unison on the first kickout pass. But instead, you're going to get beat away from any of that. You double from the weak side corner, which does nothing, and it's an open jumper. I'm switching this screen all day long. Stop. Okay, so this player's underneath Maxi Kleber. He pops. He always pops. So Rudy Gobert's up and just sending this player right in, up, and you're cutting off Luka Doncic's dribble and just sending him right into where there's a defender right there in the gaps. But instead, you do, I don't really understand what that is. So now the defense is scrambling, and now it's just an easy rip-and-go drive for a dunk. Again, I'm switching this ball screen. You run drop coverage on a pick-and-pop. You're just giving up. I mean, ever look at these rotations are late, and it ends up in a wide-open three. So here's how you rotate if you switch. Okay, again, up right here, this is Kleber. Okay, so this is Davis Bertans. So he's popping. So honestly, right here, I can just get up. I'm switching underneath, okay? And now I'm just cutting this player's dribble off here and forcing him right here into gap help. That's it. That's all. You know Bertans is popping. But instead, you're running drop coverage. So now Bertans is open, and now you rotate horribly, and it ends up in a wide open three. Another 1-3 ISO. These are so easy to double. So this player comes over here. This player's up the line here, rotates here on the kickout. This player is way over here, rotates here. And then the man that comes to double falls into this last Mavericks player in the corner. Okay? I have that option. I also have the option to send Doncic this way, but this player's got to get way further in. His right foot can be parallel to or on the block, left foot out, wide stance. And now I don't have to move my feet. So Doncic comes this way. There's just a second defender waiting. I can stunt, and then I can easily recover back to the three-point line because I don't have to move my feet inward. But, I mean, you do nothing. You just let Rudy Gobert go one-on-one on an island, and, of course, it's a two-shot foul. I'm never leaving myself on an island guarding Luka Doncic, okay? Look what I can do here. I can get up into his airspace. What does this do? Now, this player can come in, left foot parallel to the block. Well, it's actually more here. Okay, left foot parallel to the block, right foot out, wide stance. Now I'm up and sending Doncic this way. There's no place for him to go. None. There's a second defender right here. And now I can stunt without having to move my feet inward. That is the whole key. This is just the shell drill in a game. But I don't have to move my feet at all. So now I can easily recover to the three-point line. Instead, Doncic, you're just going to leave him on an island. And, I mean, he just, you know, creates things. See, I mean, I'm just never in a million years giving Luka Doncic the lane. So this now creates a two-on-one and a lob dunk, okay? Or a lob alley-oop. So anyways, again, I'm switching the screen. Switch, under. Why can I switch this screen so confidently? Because where's Luka Doncic going? This player needs to move in a little bit. But I can just send this player him this way. There's no place for him to go. Stunt, don't have to move your feet. Easy recovery, okay? But instead, you're just going to give Luka Doncic the lane in a two-on-one, and of course it ends poorly. Got to have your feet set away from the ball, okay? Let's take a look at this player. Look at how his feet are never set. See, you can't be moving your feet. Right now, right here, you should be up the line, back to the baseline, feet set. Whenever you're moving your feet inward, you're never going to get back outward. See, let's watch this again. All right, watch this player's feet right here. Okay, look at where's his feet going. See how his feet are going inward? So now he's never going to get back outward. So it's just a rip-and-go drive and a two-shot foul because Dallas is in the bonus. See, this is an easy switch. Stop. Get underneath. Okay, look what I can do here. All right, guard right here. So, again, I have multiple options. I can send this player here. I need to get up and send Doncic this way right into the second defender. Again, he can move in. He can be as far in as his left foot being parallel to the block, right foot out, wide stance. And now I don't have to move my feet. I can just stunt, recover. Okay, that will happen because I don't have to move my feet inward. Or you can wait for this player to cut through, roll through. You switch here, and now we got a 1-3 ISO. So right now this player is just going to cut off here. Again, this player comes in double team, so I'm sending him right into, see how I'm sending him right into a double team right here? So then this player then would rotate here. Okay, as this player rolls through, the man that goes to double goes on to the man that rolls through, and then the man guarding the man that rolls through just goes to the corner. So I have multiple options. But running drop coverage and giving Luka Doncic the lane is a really bad one. Cannot sag on Doncic. That can never, ever, ever happen. Right here, this player can get his back to the baseline, though. I can get up, force this player this way. Now I'm just stunting, not moving my feet at all. Stunting, so his dribble's picked up here. Easy recovery way out here where Jalen Brunson is. But instead, you're sagging, and, you know, well, Doncic is going to hit a three. You cannot switch and then switch back. That does not work, okay? And now Dallas is in the bonus. That's a two-shot foul. Stay switched, okay? Underneath, Gobert's up, all right? So when this player cuts through, right here, I can do, again, multiple things. This player can come in, okay? Left foot on the block, right foot out, wide stance. Get up, send him this way right into a second defender. Okay, I'm stunting. I don't have to move my feet. I can recover. The other option I have is watch it when this player, look at, so this player is going to roll through. We're not switching back. We're staying home. All right, so this player's right here. Force him into this double team. Okay, this player's up the line, rotates here. When this player rolls through, this player rotates to the corner, and the man that doubles takes the man that rolls through. But again, like this switch back thing is terrible.